Welcome to the Wandering Wardells. We are now going to start our ship tours and ship reviews and all that other stuff to do with the Carnival Venezia. Again, that we went on November 30th of 2023 for a 10-night cruise out of Manhattan. So we figured we'd start with the most important thing. And the most important thing for me is food. I love food. And if you love food too, or are concerned about anything to do with food on these Carnival ships, spoiler alert, the food is fantastic. So with that being said, please stick with this video right to the very end. We will give you a lot of different food options that you will see on the ship, as well as you'll actually see live shots of the various food that we ate and our honest opinions throughout of the food options. So again, stick with me and come wander with the Wardells.
Wandering, wandering, wandering Wardells. Wandering, wandering, wandering Wardells. So dream about your next vacation and I will be your guide. And share with friends and hit the like, then ring the bell, subscribe.
Normal. All right, so we're here for lunch in the buffet. So we got on the embarkation day, there's this fun, it's like a funfetti cheesecake of sorts, and apparently it's amazing. So I haven't tried mine yet, but it looks very good. And as we all know, I love desserts. They then got some pizza, which looks awesome. And John is really happy with his salad bar selection. Everything's good?
Really good.
And I got a salad as well. Okay, so I am trying this embarkation cake for the first time.
For safety reasons, cigarette smoking, including
deterring
cigarettes.
Oh, wow.
Prizes,
it's thebomb.com.
This is pretty good, too.
What do you have?
Smoking is never allowed.
Fish with parmesan and tomato. I ate everything else, except the bun.
Okay, we are standing in front of one of the many places that you can go for supper. This place has an upcharge though, so majority of our reviews on the food, in fact all of them, are going to be the restaurants that cost nothing. However, we just want to point out to you that there are several restaurants that you can pay an upcharge for, and you can look that up at your leisure. This one above me is the sign of it is Banzai Sushi, and certainly it is what it says it is. It is a sushi restaurant. And I'll show you several more restaurants. Okay, so we are right in front of another one of the specialty restaurants on the Carnival Venezia. This one here is Fahrenheit Steakhouse, and it definitely has an upcharge to it. We did try the other steakhouse on a previous cruise and it was delicious, but we are not going to be doing this one. But just of note, again, just one of the many places that you can dine for supper.
So we are again at one of the many restaurants of the Carnival Venezia. This one is called the Banzai Teppanyaki, I guess. I don't know how to say it. Anyway, it's another pay for restaurant for supper, and we're gonna just take a quick look. We're not gonna eat here, but we'll just take a quick look and show you what it's all about.
They do table side service. And if you just look to the right, there's an active service going on. But this is certainly an upcharge.
Okay, we are back in one of the many restaurants for lunch. So on top of the buffet, the burgers, the pizza, and many other things, we also have a restaurant called Pasta Bella. And here they do table service for lunch, and it is actually on the third floor, front of the ship, in one of the restaurants that they actually serve other meals as well sometimes, like your breakfast and suppers and things like that. So anyway, here we are. We will also show you, as you can see, a screenshot of the menu, but certainly it is mostly spaghettis, fancy spaghettis, etc., etc. And we'll show you what the food looks like when it comes out. So our first course has arrived, and we both got the Tuscan style tomato soup, and it's supposed to be authentic Italian. It did say it was chunky on the menu, although it isn't, but that's okay. We're gonna try it. It definitely has a homemade taste to it, and I have no complaints. Very good. Okay, the next course has arrived. We both got a caprese salad. I've already started eating mine. It's actually really good. And then just a standard salad, because every now and again you got to try to eat something that's marginally healthy before you die on one of these ships. See you with the next course. Okay, so our final course, well, what did I say, our final course? I think we're probably doing dessert, which I haven't done very much of, but I'm feeling extra hungry today. May or may not have had a few too many last night. Anyway, we for lunch now have, Michelle has a shrimp patadello or something like that. Again, you can see it in the menu. But ultimately, that it is like a lemon cream sauce or something like that, it says. And then she has a bacon carbonara or something like that. Looks very good. And I have a meatball linguine thingamajiggy in a tomato sauce. So who doesn't need more carbs at lunch? Of course, right? Yeah, same standard. Excellent. Okay, dessert has arrived. I'm already stuffed, but one of my rare desserts, but I do like chocolate cake the odd time. So this is a 7-layer chocolate cake. And this is some type of, I don't know if it's like a caramelly chocolate sauce. And then Michelle devoured hers. I mean, ate it very slowly. But we didn't get filled with it. She had a banana cream pie and I had a bite of that, and real good. So I've already had a little bite of this and it's fantastic as well. Welcome to the Marco Polo restaurant for supper. This is where we have been going to eat every night for our supper meal with our family. And at this point in the trip, sometimes you wish the kids weren't here, and I'm kidding, but I'm not, and they're sitting right beside me, and that's why I'm saying that. With that being said, we are at table 178, and when you do your specific time dining on the ship, they actually assign you a table, and you eat at that table all week. So that's kind of convenient. You don't have to check in or anything. You literally just go and have a seat directly at your table every single night for supper. So our supper time is 5:30 every night, which is a little early for us, but regardless, that's the time that we went with. The other thing I want to mention really quickly is they have the menu for you both on QR codes. They have that right on the tables, so pretty easy to use that, unless your phone sucks like mine. And then if that's the case, then you can open it up on the Carnival Hub app. So tonight will be the only night we're going to give you an example of the food that you can order on this menu, and it changes daily. Again, just last thing I will say is, again, you can order typically as many appetizers as you want and a maximum of 2 entrees per person, and after that they will do an upcharge. So very shortly, the food is going to come out, and I ordered a whole bunch of stuff to give you an example of what you will see on the supper menu. Okay, my first 2 appetizers have arrived. Just as an example again, we have escargot on this side, and over here we have actually a pork slider, and we'll keep you posted as to what comes next. Okay. Another appetizer has arrived, and I have the pumpkin soup, and let's actually give this a try. Okay, another appetizer has arrived. Trying everything, but just having a little bit of everything tonight, actually, because I'm not even that hungry, because I've been eating all day. This is called arancini, I think, some Italian thing, and I can't remember what's in here, so I'm just gonna dip it in the like a tomato sauce type of thing. So it almost tastes like a cheese ball. That's the best way I could describe it. It's good though. Okay, the last appetizer, and it is a antipasto plate with a bunch of different meats, pickle, breadsticks, olives, and then we'll show you what we got for mains.
Yeah. Okay, so we all wanted to try to keep it somewhat light. So we did a Caesar salad, then I got a Caesar salad with salmon. I just got Caesar salad with salmon, and Brody had a Caesar salad earlier and he's having salmon as well. How is it?
Good.
All right.
And last but not least, Maya got the steak, and we're zooming in on this freak right now. And that's that.
Can I see it?
Okay, we are again on level 10, center of the ship, and just like pretty much every carnival ship, if not every carnival ship, there is a Guy's Burger Joint. Now, Guy's Burger Joint, for those of you that don't know, is actually Guy Fieri, the famous chef, has partnered with Carnival, and this is his burger place. So as you see here, there's a list of burgers that you can get. I certainly will be ordering a burger on this ship at some point. I've not done so yet because I love them. They are fantastic. The other thing on this particular ship, because it is Italian style, they do have a pepperoni pizza burger. So I will certainly be trying that as well. So anyway, we thought we'd film it right now before it gets busy, because it is not open yet. When it does open, this place is always lined up. Okay, so as I said, I was gonna do another Guy's Burger thing. This particular burger is their specialty one that they have on the Carnival Venezia. I have another burger as well, but I put too many toppings on it and therefore I lost my lid. So I'm gonna just slap this down. This is their pizza burger, but I forget the name of it officially. Michelle might know, or anybody else know the name of
it.
Pepperoni pizza burger, apparently it's called, only on the Carnival Venezia. Of course I added everything. I did not double patty this though, because that'd be ridiculous. Instead I got two. So here we go.
What do you think?
It's different. I don't know if I love it or not. I will eat the whole thing, but it's definitely different. Okay, welcome to the breakfast buffet. This is the first time we've eaten here on this ship. We have a variety of everything. I have a manwich, to say the least. And then they have Eggs Benedict, scrambled eggs. They do have their omelet station. You can get eggs any way you want. They have everything, and the buffets are actually really, really, really good. So stay tuned for more food.
Hey, baby.
Okay, we are at the buffet for lunch. This is probably a terrible time to record because we've been eating constantly for a long period of time. But I just wanted to point out again, fantastic food everywhere you go here. And you're looking at a bunch of empty plates. The plates that aren't completely empty, I have a couple things left. But the desserts here are actually high quality. So I'm actually, again, contrary to what I would normally do, having dessert for lunch. For kids, hot dogs, you see it, fries, you name it. Battered fish, mac and cheese. And just below here, I also have some veal shoulder with chimichurri sauce and a little bit of gravy. And then there's some broccoli and cheese casserole thing and some mac and cheese. So, gonna continue eating. Welcome to La Strada Grill. It is on the fifth level. And on this shift, it replaces the pig and anchor, whatever it was called. Anyway, so they have some very unique options on here. Haven't tried it yet, and we may or may not get to it because I'm feeling stuffed all the time because I'm constantly eating. But again, you can see what the menu is, and just to your right, you can see it all, the people lined up to get this. And this is available every day at C from 12 to 2:30.
I am here at the deli where they make fresh sandwiches, and there is both hot and cold options. I'm just going to scan the menu.
Yeah, no sauerkraut on the hot dog.
No.
And the sandwiches are actually quite fresh and good. This is actually in the main buffet section on the 10th floor, about the center of the ship. And Michelle has gotten today some, holy, that's a big
BLT. Yeah, tons of bacon.
And then I got a chicken salad, which you can't see, as well as a tuna that we're splitting.
Welcome to, probably gonna pronounce it wrong, but Tomodoro. This is a burrito / taco place that's open throughout the day. And then they also have a topping station. And we will at some point, you will see a burrito in action. They look good. My wife had one and says they are good.
All right, now I got a burrito from, I think it's called Tomodoro. Really good. So I got beef, shrimp, rice, guacamole. Really tasty.
Welcome to the Wandering Wardells. Let me, John Wardell, inspire you for your next vacation. I will give you tips, tricks, tours, and so much more to your favorite destination. So come wander
with the Wardells. So as you can see on Carnival Cruises, the food options are endless. And the food is actually really, really, really good, in case you didn't get that from all of the video we took. You will gain weight by the second, which is not great, but you will enjoy your path to death. With that being said, our next videos are going to start to focus on all of the spaces and all of the entertainment options. So again, stick with me and keep on wandering.